Big Mom is a big problem. And I actually think on top of the roof right now, she's the biggest problem. Because this is not her arc. She's almost like a side character despite being a Yonko. This is Kaido's arc as the big bad villain. The Samurai Pirate Alliance is not here to defeat her. Even somebody like Luffy has ignored Big Mom to go after Kaido. But that's exactly what makes her even more dangerous. And honestly, I've kind of flip-flop a lot about just exactly what's gonna happen to Big Mom in this arc. But in this video, I'm gonna break down the two most likely scenarios in my opinion of what's gonna happen to Big Mom and Wano. The first one is amnesia. Now, this is not a very popular thing that Oda utilized with Big Mom, but it was still a major element in the Wano story. The reason that Big Mom did not cause as much trouble as she could have was because of amnesia. Before she could really do anything else, King knocked her off the waterfall, she hit her head and then forgot about everything, and she turned into her childhood self, which later got named Olin. And in this amnesia state, we actually see Big Mom just like her kid self, actually a nice kid, actually caring about people. Like when she was a little kid in Elbaf, she wanted everybody to eat at the table no matter what race you were. She cared about Mother Caramel, she cared about her friends, she actually has some sympathy and humanity. We saw that with Olin as well. She was nice to the villagers, she was nice to Chopper and Tama, and even when she got angry about the Oshiruko, she went on to explain that she wanted to share it with the villagers and other people. So Big Mom as Olin is actually a very nice, sweet, polite, terrifying woman. But of course, this couldn't last forever as she gets headbutted by Queen and Udon and gets turned back into the terrifying Big Mom. But is that really the end of this amnesia? Was that plot point really just used to create this ticking time bomb as Big Mom went to Udon and to make sure Big Mom didn't cause as much trouble as she could have? A lot of people don't think so, and even the people that did not like this amnesia plot point think it could be coming back. Those people are terrified anytime Big Mom hits her head, like Franky ran her over with the bike. People were thinking she might go back into amnesia. So although you might not have liked Big Mom getting amnesia, you can't deny that this plot device could very well return. And Big Mom getting amnesia was not my favorite either, but it has kind of grown on me. Because as we saw in Whole Cake Island as well, Big Mom's biggest flaw, her biggest downfall, is her lack of control. Even though she's incredibly strong, even though she has a good understanding of her goals and like what she wants to accomplish, she could just completely lose control, whether that's due to some emotional thing like Mother Caramel's picture breaking, getting hungry and going on a rampage, or even just hitting her head and going into amnesia. Big Mom's biggest flaw is that she easily loses control and she's not really in control. The only reason the Big Mom pirates are as capable as they are is mainly because of Katakuri really running the show behind the scenes, along with other people like Peril Sparrow. So although all these hunger pangs and amnesia makes Big Mom look very bad, they're supposed to. They highlight the flaws of Big Mom, and you gotta accept that's just part of who she is. And it could just be her downfall in Wano. Now, Big Mom losing in Wano due to amnesia would make it very convenient. You want something more satisfying for her, somebody as big as her, somebody as strong as her. And I do fully agree with that, but I think there is a scenario where you could have Big Mom defeated and going into amnesia. Amnesia essentially would be her defeating blow. But in order for that to happen, you will need more help up top on the roof than there is right now. See, in either one of these scenarios that I'm gonna present, I do think Kaido will be defeated. Kaido is the focus of the arc as the villain, and if you look at the story pattern of Wano, it's not very different from all the other kingdom-saving arcs before. You have Luffy meeting a group of people that he considers friends, he learns about the terrible state of the country and what is happening, and then essentially he decides to help his friends save the country and defeat the big bad. The same exact thing is happening here in Wano, it's just that the big bad is Kaido, so it's a lot different. But that's why he has so much help, and there's been such a long buildup. And I do think with the training he's gotten and the help he has right now, he could and will defeat Kaido. But Big Mom, on the other hand, I don't think there's enough manpower on the roof right now to also take her down. So if Big Mom were to be defeated in Wano and get knocked into amnesia or something like that, I think you need more forces up there and some like really strong people. Somebody like Marco has to go up there. Maybe Skopper Gabon is there and he goes up there. Whitebeard Pirates, the Marines. You're gonna need more fighting power to defeat both Yonko. And also with Big Mom, similar to Kaido, I think Luffy has to be the one to deliver that killing blow as well. Not killing, but like the final blow that defeats the opponent. So maybe while Luffy is first focusing on Kaido with Zoro there helping him, I think Kid could be a likely option to go and take on Big Mom for a while. Then you could get some stronger people to come in, Whitebeard Pirate, Skopper, or Marco, or somebody like that to help Kid out, do a lot more damage to Big Mom before maybe Kaido's defeated somehow and Luffy comes back and defeat Big Mom. mom. I know it sounds crazy because it's two Yonko that Luffy is defeating here, but if we're riding with the scenario that both of them get defeated, I think Luffy has to do both. And amnesia could be a way to kind of shortcut the damage that they need to do to Big Mom. So maybe all Luffy has to kind of showcase is that he gets the upper hand before landing that hard hit and knocking Big Mom into amnesia. That's another thing you have to consider. Big Mom going into amnesia and getting out of amnesia, the two cases we've seen, it wasn't that much attack power that was applied to her. The first time was just her falling off a waterfall, which sure is a big fall, but that's Big Mom we're talking about. And the second time was a headbutt from Queen, which again, it's Queen in his own form, but it was just one attack. I think Luffy can easily deliver an attack of that scale as he is right now. So essentially amnesia now becomes a shortcut to defeat Big Mom, but we still get to see Luffy do a lot more damage, maybe Kid showcase a lot more, and some other allies coming to help as well. But what exactly happens after Big Mom going into amnesia? Is she just Olin forever and just becomes an ally? And the answer is yeah, kinda, but not really. I don't think she essentially becomes an ally and is now friendly. Amnesia to me is not Big Mom's path of redemption. Instead, it's more so highlighting her downfall. Big Mom should not just be redeemed as Olin and become a good character. She's a terrible person, and that's the main reason she needs an actual loss and people want to see her take an actual L, because she's a terrible person. She treats her family poorly, she treats her citizens poorly, she's just this big spoiled brat. So if amnesia just permanently turns her into an ally as Olin, essentially wiping away all her sins, that would not be satisfactory. But if you see her kind of get defeated and then she turns into Olin but is essentially just a big baby, that's an outcome I think I can accept. And with this option, you might be thinking, how's everybody else gonna respond? Well, the world government, first off, probably will be happy that Big Mom is no longer a threat. The main people that would be opposed to this would be the Big Mom pirates, but right now they're nowhere to be seen. The only person that's actually there right now is Peril Sparrow, and he's occupied with Wanda and Carrot. And I don't think the rest of the Big Mom pirates are making it up there anytime soon. The first time they got knocked off, it took them like weeks before they got back up. So the only person that could really prevent this is Peril Sparrow, and I don't think he's enough to do that. So by the time the rest of the Big Mom pirates get up there, Big Mom might already become Olin. And then what happens after that? Are they gonna be the ones to try to punch Big Mom in the head? Knowing how terrifying she is, just for the chance that they might be able to turn her back to that terrifying, terrible mother, I don't think anybody would take that risk. Also, Olin will probably not remember them either, so she might even treat them as enemies. So I don't think the Big Mom pirates will be able to do anything about it, and actually, somebody like Katakuri would probably be happy about this. Without Big Mom in her sane state, although she's very strong, she's not gonna be much of a threat, and with that, you're probably gonna see the Big Mom pirates' power structure start to crumble and split up. Somebody like Peril Sparrow will probably go off on his own and create his own pirate crew, but Katakuri should be leading a big division of the Big Mom pirates and people that support him, and he will 100% take in Big Mom, although she's a terrible person, because she's family. Katakuri's the actual person that cares about the family and wants to take care of all his siblings, and Big Mom as Olin essentially has the same ideology. So Katakuri should be able to nurture and control Big Mom. Essentially, he just becomes a babysitter. His crew is obviously not as strong anymore, but at least he could guarantee the safety of his siblings. So with this amnesia option, I think that's how it's likely to play out. Big Mom also gets defeated in Wano, with amnesia being her downfall and a shortcut to defeat her. She no longer is a threat to her family or the rest of the world, and Katakuri has to babysit her. This is what I mostly initially believed, and I still think it's a very likely option, but there is a second option. And this second option makes Big Mom a much bigger problem, and it centers around her betraying Kaido. Because although Big Mom has her shortcomings of being out of control, she does have a lot of good motivations and does understand what actions to really take, and that's backed by her going after the Third Eye tribe with Pudding to try to read Poneglyphs. Even recently, you saw her talk about Robin and getting her. She's actually fully focused on becoming the Pirate King and know what steps she has to take to get there. And this Kaido Big Mom alliance is obviously not gonna last, and it definitely does feel like Big Mom has some sort of plan to betray Kaido later on. She even told Peril Sparrow, it's like, hey, you guys gotta trust me, I know what I'm doing. And honestly, we still really don't know the goal of the alliance between these two Yonko. We know it's to get ancient weapons and the One Piece and become the Pirate King, but we really don't know what really appealed to each side to go into this alliance. So I actually think Big Mom is the smarter one in this alliance, and she has a better plan of how to betray Kaido and get things her way. I feel like Kaido mostly went into this alliance partially because of that favor he owed Big Mom of giving him his devil fruit, and then he probably was like, okay, let me get her power as well. It'll just make things easier. I actually think this might be the downfall of Kaido, him not really understanding alliances and how they work, not trusting other people, but also underestimating the people of his alliance. One of such examples could be Orochi coming back to life and showcasing that Kaido underestimated Orochi, and Big Mom betraying him would tie into that as well. And then on the other side, you have an example of an actually successful pirate alliance with Luffy, something he thought was impossible but ends up defeating him. I think that is something that's definitely been pushed forward about Kaido and his distrust of everybody and how he rules by strength. So I think Big Mom having a better plan than Kaido and betraying him, eventually leading to his defeat, makes a lot of sense. Big Mom right now is in a position of advantage. She could kind of read the war and see how each side is fighting, how the tides are turning, and kind of flip-flop to really determine the outcome of this war. Currently, she's siding with Kaido because he's also a Yonko, perhaps the strongest person in the world, so it makes sense to back him. But if Luffy and gang start to turn the tide against Kaido and things are not going as well, Big Mom jumping sides, not necessarily completely jumping sides, but like doing some damage to Kaido, that will absolutely devastate Kaido and his side, because now you have a Yonko as a third party that's also against you. And for those of you that don't believe Luffy is strong enough to take down Kaido right now, this could be a shortcut for defeating Kaido too. Or it could be after Luffy defeats Kaido with his own power and then Big Mom does like some other thing and like controls Kaido or something like that. Either way, in this scenario, Kaido is also getting defeated, but now Big Mom becomes the bigger problem. She betrays Kaido, leads to his demise, but then later you have to deal with her as well. And as far as what happens after that, I think she will actually quickly leave Wano because of some sort of third party coming in. You can't have Kaido defeated and now Big Mom essentially rules Wano as the strongest person there. So whether like the Marines showing up or Vegapunk and the SSG or maybe even somebody like Blackbeard, I think something would cause Big Mom to get up and leave. But she's not gonna just leave without gaining anything. First off, she's definitely gonna grab the Road Poneglyph or a copy of it. She's probably gonna want to go after Luffy as well, but maybe she doesn't have enough time to do that, or like Zoro's protecting him or somebody's protecting him, but maybe she's able to capture Robin and kidnap Robin and leave. That would be a pretty dreadful scene. Like after Kaido is defeated, Big Mom now is the bigger problem. Luffy is exhausted and Big Mom goes up to Luffy and doesn't kill him, but instead kidnaps one of his crew members and leaves. This would essentially end Wano and everything we've been building up to, because Kaido is defeated, but now you spur a lead into the next arc with the Straw Hats now chasing after Big Mom. If it's Robin that Big Mom kidnaps, Law will also stay with the Straw Hats and go after Big Mom because he needs Robin to read the Poneglyphs and give him information on the Will of D. And if the tragedy of Killer dying happens and Kid has a bigger reason to fight Big Mom, maybe he gets involved as well and joins the mission as well. And as much as a nice little break after Wano to settle down a little bit, it feels like Oda is really ramping everything up into this final arc, so this might be the way to do it. Essentially, Wano as a story is kind of wrapped up, but you can't even have that big celebration in the end because Robin is not there. And as far as where Big Mom would go next, Elbaf makes the most sense. Maybe the Other Road Poneglyph is there, and that's why Big Mom really wanted the giant's powers. Shanks could also be tied to Elbaf. It would be a big arc for Usopp as well, so a lot of things could all happen in Elbaf, and it might even be a bigger arc than Wano. We did also get confirmation from Oda that Shanks will be making a move in 2021, and it should be all coming together into this final arc of One Piece, so Big Mom going to Elbaf, tying some loose ends there as well. That definitely could make a lot of sense. You could also have Beige and Lola and Chiffon return to the story because of Lola and Chiffon's friendship with not only the Straw Hats, but Nami. Lola also rejected the marriage of Prince Loki, so you could expand on that story, and that way you would get the reunion of Nami and Lola, and also Lola and Big Mom, and also Luffy and Nami and Pound. Maybe that's why Oda spent super long on a Capone Beige cover story. So yeah, this is the likely path, in my opinion, if Big Mom does not get defeated in Wano. The biggest thing I'm uncertain about in this theory is Big Mom in particular being able to capture Robin. First off, it's almost like another repeat of Enies Lobby, so it might be a little repetitive, but also in Zoe when Inarashi and Nekomamushi talked about the Road Poneglyphs, and they specifically said to Robin, you really need to be careful now because of your ability to read Poneglyphs, and then Robin was like, it's fine, I have super strong crewmates to protect me. So if she was actually captured by Big Mom, it would kind of be detrimental to the Straw Hats. At the same time though, you could have Robin just showcasing confidence and then of course Luffy defeating Big Mom and getting Robin back. Also at the same time, I just don't want anything bad to happen to Robin, so maybe don't kidnap Robin and take somebody else. The other thing with this is like how much else will be happening in Elbaf with a lot of people speculating it's also Shanks' arc, and then Usopp should be getting a lot of shine as well with all his connections. So there's definitely a lot of parts to this theory that probably wouldn't happen. But I think if Big Mom does not get defeated in Wano, this is a very likely path. But yeah, those are the two main ideas for what I think Big Mom's fate in Wano will be. But what about you guys? What do you think about these two theories? Do you have any theories of your own? Let me know in the comments below. But as always, thank you guys for watching. I hope you enjoyed. If you did enjoy, please hit that like button. To keep up with this channel, you gotta hit that subscribe button, hit the bell to get notified. Thank you to all my King Pirates Elite members for your support. The King Pirates Discord is linked in the description below, which, by the way, I'm looking for somebody to help me really run this server as I focus more on this channel. So if you have experience with Discord and bots and all that sort of stuff and running a Discord and growing this Discord is something you're interested in, definitely join the Discord and hit me up. But yeah, also follow me on Twitter. I'm DKing4, which hopefully it's not private anymore and Shueisha is done striking everybody. But I'll see you guys next time. Peace.